Alrighty, welcome to another modern video here on ChannelFireball.com. We've got Amulet Titan today. So what this deck's trying to do is combine Amulet of Vigor with bounce lands like Simic Growth Chamber, because that combination means that the Growth Chamber enters the battlefield and then immediately untaps. You then return the Growth Chamber itself to your hand, and you get to play it two additional times thanks to Azusa Lost But Seeking. Summer Bloom is actually banned from this deck, which is why this deck, has seen not as much play recently. It's also got Sakura Tribe Scout, lets you put these bounce lands back into play. What you do with that is you get up to 6 mana, and you get Primeval Titan. And then the classic is to get Boros Garrison plus Slayer's Stronghold, at which point those both untap thanks to the amulet, and then you give the Titan +2/+0 Vigilance and Haste. You can get more, you get to attack, get 2 more lands. You can use Sun Home to give it Double Strike, so that's already 16 damage. And then sometimes you can get multiple Titans into play. You also have the combo of getting Teleria West plus a bounce land, returning the bounce land, and then transmuting Teleria West, which gets you Summoner's Pact, which gets you another Titan. It's also got Walking Ballista, Pact Negation, and Explosives as tutor targets for that Teleria West, and Ballista get extra damage through two. Trinket Mage can pick up Amulet or Explosives. And then Ancient Stirrings, of course, is one of the key parts of the deck. This is one of the big Ancient Stirrings decks. It's got a lot of utility lands, so it's got Academy Ruins, Bojuka Bog, so like Ruins to get back killed Amulets, Explosives, or Ballistas, Bojuka Bog against graveyard decks, Kabira Crossroads if you need to gain 2 life, Cavern of Souls against decks with counters, Vesuva just gets to copy anything, lets you double up on some of your sweet lands, get multiple Slayer Strongholds perhaps, and then Ghost Quarter to destroy a land. It's also got Colony Garden to get a little blocker there, and to protect against Edicts like Liliana's Edict. This particular build has Coalition Relic and Sakura Tribe Scout as additional ways to hardcast Primeval Titan besides just Azusa. Stop. And the Coalition Relic also helps because against something like Blood Moon, turn 3 Relic, it's still just turn 4 Titan. The combo of Coalition Relic Primeval Titan is pretty powerful. Sideboard's got a bunch of Summoner's Pack targets like Hornet Queen, Chameleon Colossus, Ramunap Excavator to get lands, and then Rurik Thar as a way to punish decks that have a bunch of disrupting spells. Somehow I managed 2 different versions of Path. 4 copies of Path to Exile against the aggressive decks, and then Negates and Spell Pierces against combo or control. Another Tormod's Crypt against graveyard decks, and Explosives against the decks that are weak to explosives is decks like Bogles, or decks that have a lot of cheap permanents. And then Emrakul is another big finisher if the game goes long. All right, this deck's hard to play. I haven't played this deck in quite some time, so let's take this into a modern league and see what we can learn from that. Alrighty, I would in fact like to play first, and this hand looks great to me. It's only got one land, but it's got Ancient Stirrings, so I can go ahead and find a bounce land. So the question, and this is why where this deck, the difficulty of this deck comes in, what do I do on turn one? I've got 3 different options, because I have 3 different 1-mana spells. My inclination is to just go turn 1 Stirrings to try to find a bounce land. Then I can go turn 2 Amulet, play the bounce land. Other options, turn 1 Sakura Tribe Scout, turn 2... Actually, that even sounds better. Turn 1 Sakura Tribe Scout lets me potentially go turn 2 Stirrings for a bounce land, put bounce land into play, bounce Gemstone Mine, replay Gemstone Mine, play Amulet or something along those lines. Well, now I wish I had cast Stirrings on turn 1, so potentially Thoughtseize is a reason not to do that, because now my opponent can take Ancient Stirrings and leave me pretty out of luck. Though, if I hit a bounce land just off the top here, then I get to go off pretty nicely. So, shall we draw a Simic Growth Chamber? No, another Azusa. I think I'm going to play an Amulet and then hit for 1 here, and then hopefully I draw a bounce land or an Ancient Stirrings. I can't really cast anything else. Okay, we're playing as Wurr Prison here, so this is the deck trying to lock your opponent out with chalices, needles. Sure, you could name Sakura Tribe Scout, I suppose. Could also name Engineered Explosives. Oh, Teleria West. Yeah, there's a lot of options here. Then they get to Ancient Stirrings. They had to play their artifact first. Oh, this is actually just traditional Lantern. Okay, Forest. Just play another Amulet, I think. Hit for 1. problem here is even if I draw a bounce land, I then have a lot of mana, but I don't have I don't have much I can do with that mana. All right, let's just play another Sakura Tribe Scout and hit. My opponent has the Lantern Lock going here. And at this point, as it turns out, had I even hit a bounce land, it wouldn't have done a whole lot for me because I still am very short of any sort of action here. Opponent's stirring things up here. They have a Pyxis of Pandemonium, so they get to use Lantern, they get to look at my top card, and they get to exile it if it's not to their satisfaction. Ghost Quarter, sure. And they revealed Ghost Quarter and Ghost Quarter's on top. I'm going to play another Lantern. And I'm going to try to kill them with Sakura Tribe Scouts and potentially a Azusa here. I'm actually just going to hit for two and then play Azusa and see if we can get things done that way. That's a not exactly plan A, but not a whole lot else I can do. What is going on? Why can't I cast Azusa? Alright. Azusa is lost, but now seeking. Opponent gets to mill themselves. Now they're essentially milling themselves. They're using Pyxis to clear out their draw step, so this is the other side of Lantern. And now Ghoul Caller's Bell. They're going to get to look at a lot of cards to find Ensnaring Bridge, if, in fact, they don't already have it. This is not good. Anything that costs more than one mana is probably pretty bad. Oh, Collective Brutality. Sure, I can live with that. Okay, there's a Primeval Titan, which I don't think I'm going to get to draw here. And they've got a Ghoul Caller's Bell coming up. They can use Pyxis here. Oh, they're Abrupt Decaying. Oh, Assassin's Trophy. Yeah, sure, I guess. I'll get a forest. There was no real reason to keep the Titan on top. I already knew that my opponent was going to get to mill it. Oh, there's an Ensnaring Bridge. Okay, that's unfortunate. Kaya Orzo versus the Usurper. Interesting. So I go to seven here. I have seen Kaya. I guess this is the list that Sam Black was playing. All right, so Kaya, and then now I think we're pretty dead, because at this point my opponent can just use the Ghoul Caller's Bell and the Pyxis to lock me out, and has an Ensnaring Bridge to make it so I can't attack anymore with Azusa. Okay, so I definitely want explosive spell pierces and negates, Rexage for sure. Rurikthar actually seems, it's expensive, but it actually seems like it could do. Could do some work. Pack Negation, less good. These are a little good reactive counterspells. Pact is a more proactive counterspell. It's not really what I'm looking for here. It's just still way too many cards. So what do we not want? I mean, I don't think I need... Like, this deck's got tons of lands, so you can kind of cut some of the less useful utility lands here. Should I slow the deck down by taking out a couple Sakura Tribe Scouts? That seems fine to me, especially if I'm looking to use explosives for one here. All right, and I don't want to cut Colony Garden. I guess I could cut Cavern of Souls, or I could cut Cat. No, Academy Ruins actually could be really good here, and I think Ghost Quarter is okay too. Let's just cut the Colony Garden and get back in there. Though, actually, Ramanumpa Excavator sounds like it could be pretty decent. Let's slow the deck down a little bit and take out the Skur Tribe Scouts, put in Ramanumpa Excavator there as well. Alright, I would like to play first. I think this hand is fine. It's not great. I mean, neither of these hands, like that last hand was close to being great, but ended up not being didn't get there. This hand is very clearly not great, but I think it's keepable. Especially against a deck with Inquisitions and Thought Seizes and whatnot, Collective Brutality is like, I don't know, I don't like mulliganing too much against a deck that's looking to disrupt you immediately already. Just because having a hand like this that has a stable mana base and a couple good action spells seems pretty good. Okay, Lantern is fine. I'm just going to play Simic Growth Chamber. Bounce my land. Pass. They are drawing Mox Opal. Oh, and hitting another Mox Opal. Alright, and then Ancient Stirring into an Ensnaring Bridge ashore. Into Inventor's Fair, okay. Rexage isn't bad. So I think here I just play Tolaria West. No reason to play Vesuva. And then I'm going to pass because I like drawing Rexage, so I don't want to shuffle that away. I don't want to Ancient Stirrings that away. And I like having Spell Pierce up. Gives my opponent play something a little more expensive here. Well, that's annoying. I can't Spell Pierce the Thoughtseize, but I can Spell Pierce whatever comes next. It's not that I'm worried that they'll take Spell Pierce, though. I suppose they could if they really wanted to resolve something this turn. It's more that now that they know I have Spell Pierce in hand, it gets a significant amount less effective. But I think that's fine, because then next turn I can Rexage potentially, or I could just go Azusa, play some stuff. Okay, so they have an Ensnaring Bridge in hand. I still don't need to do anything else here, so let's just go Azusa. Let's get our mana base going here. Simic Growth Chamber, Eternal Land, and Larry West, and then Celestia Sanctuary, Eternal Land. And this is emulating the hard way, kind of, but I still think it's okay. And then now they're going to go Needle on Tolaria West here. And then Ensnaring Bridge. I'm going to have this Spell Pierce kind of rotting in my hand. But then I can Rexage. Oh, they're needling a Walking Ballista? Interesting. So let's transmute. Yeah, transmute this for Summoner's Pact. And then play Reclamation Sage on Ensnaring Bridge. Don't care about the Needle Walking Ballista here. And then I can play Vesuva here. I guess it's probably better to play Vesuva than not. And then I just copy Inventor's Fair. Yeah, that sounds... Because I know I'm not drawing a... Amulet anytime soon. I guess Inventor's Fair is pretty far from getting used. Could just get a Cadmir Rune, sure. Oh, and I get to attack for one. And then they get to gain one. And so my opponent's on Unmoored Ego. Interesting. And they have access to 5 mana, so they can play around Spell Pierce here. I don't think I care that much about Unmoored Ego, so they have their bridge here. They have no cards in hand. Okay, they just played the Mox to not take damage here. So now, sadly, they can't summon respect for another Reclamation Sage, so I can get a Titan here. I still think that's probably good. So let's go ahead and get... Oh, I could get Rurikthar. Huh. That's interesting. So if I just get Rurikthar, I guess I can just do that next turn. So I can get Primeval Titan. I can get Tolaria West and a Bounce Land. They're drawing Unmoored Ego, but they're not going to know about Rurikthar. Oh, but I'm not going to be able to Tolaria West this turn. Then they could Unmoored Ego for Summoner's Packs. But I can also just get Explosives. Okay, yeah, let's just get Primeval Titan here. Oh, this is... I guess I need to tap more manas. All right. Prime Time. And I want Tolaria West. And I guess I want another Simic Growth Chamber. Yeah, I don't really need Academy Runes. All right, let's just get some Growth Chamber. Let's bounce Tolaria West. And then I'm going to play Boros Garrison, bounce Vesuva, and then I could just replay Vesuva if I want. I guess there's... So next turn I'm going to spend 4 on the Pact. Yeah, sure. Let's get copy Academy runs again and pass the turn. All right. They're going to draw and play Unmoored Ego here. That's not going to bother me a whole lot. I guess they have Academy runes out too, so I do have to watch out for that. There comes a Lantern. Okay, so let's see what they'd name with Unmoored Ego. Unmoored Ego is a pretty funny one. It makes sense in this matchup especially, and I understand why the Lantern deck does want it. But, I'm going to get Teleria West. Oh, I see. Okay. So Teleria West is going to get exiled. I'm going to draw a card. I'm going to pay four. And I suppose what I'm looking for at this point is I do need to find... Oh, Negate. Okay, Negate's not the worst. Okay, so let's pay four. Draw, play Celestia Sanctuary. Get back Academy Ruins. I could Vesuva Inventor's Fair, but yeah, it doesn't do anything. So let's just pass with Vesuva in hand. I'll just wait, and then my opponent gets to draw Lantern of Insight, but they don't have a lock going. Well, Thoughtseize actually is not too bad, because Thoughtseize actually lets them. Actually, I'm going to Vesuva Inventor's Fair. Oh, I guess I can't even sack this, because this Ballista... Actually, I'm just going to play this for it all. There's no real reason not to, because they can Thoughtseize me, but if they Thoughtseize me, they're taking the gate anyway. I'd rather just resolve. I guess I only want an Inventor's Fair because as a shuffle effect, but I don't even actually have enough artifacts out to do that. Oh, they're going to upkeep Inventor's Fair? Well, that's bizarre. And they're going to Lantern? What? Okay. Yeah, I mean, I guess getting Engineer Explosives is good there, but... They didn't feel like they needed to go quite to that length to do that. I guess I need to find a Rurikthar now to kill them. They could have just drawn Thoughtseize and Thoughtseized. All right, well, I'm going to negate that for sure. I know they have Academy Runes, but next turn, you know, there's not a whole lot I can do about that. Okay, well, floating two mana in response to negate doesn't do a whole lot, because that's not a spell pierce. Draw now, because now I get to Ghost Quarter Academy Runes. And then they don't get to get back their Lantern. And now I get to draw Summoner's Pact and play Rurikthar. And then they have to play spells and they'll eventually die to it. Oh. Assassin's Trophy. Gross. Ooh, another Summoner's Pact. I don't think the second Summoner's Pact does a whole lot for me. They're drawing Assassin's Trophy. Play my land and pass here. Oh, I know what I can do. I've got a plan. So I'm going to draw. They're going to play that Assassin's Trophy on my Inventor's Fair. All right. No. And then I'm going to draw Summoner's Pact. So I can Summoner's Pact here. I can get Rurikthar. And then, let's see, six. Yeah, and then I can Summoner's Pact here. And I can get Romanop Excavator. And then Romanop Excavator plus Ghost Quarter is eventually going to get all their lands here. Mm-hmm. Let's see how many more basics they have. Oh, I should have actually waited because I knew they were drawing Welding Jar. I got a little hasty there. All right, but then I get to play Rurikthar. And they have to play spells into Rurikthar. And then they take 6 damage when they do. Yeah, this is great. And then draw. Alright, well, I should probably pay for my Summoner's Packs. Oh man, games against Lantern are really sweet sometimes. and then play Ghost Quarter, and now I actually don't want to play sack the Ghost Quarter because I do want to. Oh wait, I can play multiple lands. Wow. All right. Because I do want to keep Ghost Quarter from getting surgicled here. Yeah, they're just dead now. This is great. And explosive doesn't matter. So now let's Ghost Quarter your Spire of Industry. If they surgical, then that's fine. And then now I can just pass. Oh, I can actually attack with the Azusa even. And pass the turn. And I don't really know how they get out of this. They're basically bridge locked, where in order to not die to my creatures, they have to play spells into Rurikthar. 6 damage per spell is a lot. That is not cheap. And then even without the Rurikthar, I would eventually get them with a Ghost Quarter plus Ramanop Excavator, where they would not be able to play spells anymore. So now I can actually Ghost Quarter them out. They can't even surgical this one. This is so sweet. Who's the Lantern deck now? Well, they're still the Lantern deck, but I am grinding them out. Okay. Actually, I should for sure have Emrakul the Promised End in my deck. It's just a card that does something in a spot like that. I still don't want Pact or any Bog or any of those things. Spell Pierce actually looking kind of bad. It's just so hard for this deck to leave Spell Pierce up. So, all right. Game 3. Let's see what we got here. I'm going to keep this hand. It needs an amulet, but can be decent with an amulet, and it's got a lot of action in it. Ancient Stirrings. I kind of don't like having Rurik in my hand, just because of Thoughtseize. I'd rather have Rurikthar hiding safely in my library for the time at which I want to summon him, because Rurikthar seems really important in this matchup. All right, let's just play Forest. Playing against a bunch of Thoughtseizes and Unmoored Egos and whatnot. Yeah, they have to needle. I mean, they need needle because they need to needle explosives. It is kind of brutal for them that, like, it just isn't great that they have to just always needle explosives, and then Rexage can still get them and Walking Ballista can still get them. Here's Unmoored Ego. No, here's the Ensnaring Bridge that I still don't really care about. And then I go Azusa. Celestia Sanctuary. Return Gemstone Mine. Play Gemstone Mine. The reason I didn't play the Boros Garrison is if I do draw an Amulet, I'd rather have a Bounce Land. And then now I can just play Rurik. Yeah, another bridge is fine. A bridge too far. Let's just play Rurikthar. So once I have Rurik in play, I mean, they could. Assassin's Trophy it, but I wouldn't be too worried about that. Whatever. I actually probably should have thought about what I was going to name. Ooh, I get to attack, sure. But I think that's fine. And then the next turn, I can start getting Primeval Titan. They have to basically have Assassin's Trophy, like, right now. Ghost Quarter's not super relevant. Right, let's get Summoner's Pact into prime time. Because they have, my opponent has 2 Ensnaring Bridges, it doesn't really seem productive to get a Rexage. So let's get... Definitely getting 1 Teleria West. The question is, do I get 2? I guess I could have saved 2 Bounce Lands. Let's just get 1 Teleria West, and actually, Academy Ruins doesn't do a whole lot. And then Vesuva? Oh, let's just get the Bounce Land. And then play Gemstone Mine and Transmute T West here for... Probably just another Summoner's Pact. I could get an Explosive doesn't do anything. I could get a Walking Ballista here. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 mana. Walking Ballista is decent. let's just do that. And then play another land. And then hit with Azusa. And then now my opponent has a bunch of things they need to get rid of in order to get out of this game. Okay, so they're going to search for something with Inventor's Fair here. Another needle, maybe? Yep. And now they can needle Walking Ballista, but they take 6 damage while doing so. And then... yeah, I just get to pay for my pact here. And I'm not doing a whole lot else. Draw, negate would be a good draw. I am going to Ghost Quarter Inventor's Fair, though, so I don't get to tutor again. Play a land, and I'm going to play Walking Ballista for just some amount. I guess some is 3. Actually, 3 is kind of good, because that way they have to play a card next turn in order to prevent Ballista and Azusa from attacking, and they only get to play 2 more spells this game before dying. So their first spell really has to be Assassin's Trophy, or Rurikthar is just going to demolish them here. Well, turned out having Rurikthar on the sideboard pretty clutch. Opponent in the classic Lantern dilemma of, it feels like there's a way out of this if I do it right, but they don't really know what it is. It's just hard to play that deck, and it's all about cutting off all of your opponent's escape routes. But in this particular case, Rurikthar the Unbowed, whacking them over the head every time they play a non-creature spell. And that plus Ensnaring Bridge means, well, they've got to play something in order to get out of this, and it does not look like they're going to have a good time doing so. Again, if they have Assassin's Trophy, kill Rurik, they go to 6, then they have a pretty good shot this game. But they apparently did not, and we are 1-0, perfectly played with Amulet Titan here. Alrighty, time for round 2. I'm on the draw. This hand looks... So I'm going turn 1 land, go. Turn 2 land, go. Turn 3 Trinket Mage for Amulet. Down. This seems too slow. Well, this does not. I'm going to keep this hand. Yeah, I want Azusa. I do need to hit a way to either play a Titan, find or play a Titan. But don't have those quite yet. Let's see. Opponent on Flooded Strand. Into Steam Vents, I'm sure. No, Basic Island. Into Opt. Okay, so we're playing against like blue-white. Okay, well that makes me wish I'd kept the first hand, because that was a pretty slow hand, and you'd actually be slow in that matchup. Let's play Amulet here. Gemstone Mine into Ancient Stirrings. And can't get the Titan. Given what I have, it's awkward that I have all the like non-Teleria West lands. I have no blue lands. I could just get Simic Growth Chamber. No, I'm just gonna get Teleria West still. This deck has more ways to find bounce lands and more bounce lands than it has ways to find Titans. So I'd rather just do that. And then next turn I get to play Celestia Sanctuary, it untaps, just return it to my hand. Classic. So you want to stack it this way, so you untap with the Amulet first, tap it for green, return this, attempt to play Azusa. She's lost, but she is seeking. Play Amulet, untap it. Tap it for mana. So I've played, I get one additional land play. And then I think I do this. Untap. Tap this for 2. And I think I'm just going to return this and play a ballista for two here. And we'll see what my opponent does. I could have cycled the Talaria West this turn, but if Azusa doesn't live this turn, I think I'd rather just have a ballista in play and then try to set up that next turn. Because drawing the second Talaria West means I can play one of them. Okay, we're getting Supreme Verdicted. Ping, ping. Okay. Amulet goes in the stack, and then I'm going to transmute for a Summoner's Pact. Pass the turn here. So I kind of want to find another blue source. Oh, Coalition Relic's interesting. Let's go Amulet. Untap this. I'm actually just going to return Gemstone Mine here. And then cast Coalition Relic. See how that goes. If my opponent counters Coalition Relic, they counter Coalition Relic. I'm not actually that worried about that. Coalition Relic, pretty good in this matchup. Just gives you a way to start casting your spells without being so all-in on the combo. And then your opponent still has to deal with it kind of as a threat if they want to cut you off on mana. So now my plan is to transmute Talaria West for Cavern of Souls. Well, okay, that might be a little more difficult. Put a charge counter on this. They can go ahead and take my Summoner's Pact. Okay, Ancient Stirring's not so bad. I still have some good optionality here. I get to transmute. I get to Stirrings. There's a lot of things I could find here. And click is good because it gives my opponent a clock, but it's not like that fast of a clock. So let's add blue and green. Ancient Stirrings here. Into mostly nonsense. Okay. Well, let's just get Simic Growth Chamber. And add blue. Transmute here. Let's get Summoner's Pact again. Play Simic Growth Chamber. Untap it. Bounce Talaria West. And I still think I transmute this now. Unfortunately, I do have to tap relics. I don't get the benefit, but of getting to charge it up here. But I do get to pick up Cavern of Souls here. And then next turn I can go Pact for Titan, Cavern of Souls. But I also don't want to play Cavern of Souls until the turn I'm casting Titan, in case they have Field of Ruin or something along those lines. You also got to watch out for Summoner's Pact, but if you resolve a Titan, that shouldn't be too bad, because then you get to get enough lands to pay for the pact next turn. So I've gone through three Talaria Wests, which is, I think, all of them, actually. Whoop, taking a look here. Yeah, that is all the Talaria Wests, so this Titan can't fetch additional Titans, which is a good thing to keep an eye on as well. Ooh, my opponent cryptics my Coalition Relic end of turn. Okay, I can live with that. So next turn, I think I just start by going Summoner's Pact, see if it resolves. If it does, get grab Primeval Titan and then play Cavern and play an uncounterable Primeval Titan. It sounds like a pretty good sequence of plays here. And then I could, I could get Slayer's Stronghold plus Boros Garrison. So the problem with that, oh, I see. They're just going to, this is a good sign for me. Yeah, the problem with that is that would actually lose to Cryptic Command, but oh. And then we just drew Primeval Titan. Funny. Well, let's I don't have enough mana to do it all. I could actually do it all here. I could Summoner's Pact, play Azusa, and play three lands. All right, let's actually see. Actually, let's tap this for mana. So I'm actually going to do it this way, so that way if they path Azusa, I still get an extra land play out of the deal. I'm going to return Kabira Crossroads to hand. Play Azusa. Play Simic Growth Chamber. And this is the part where they should path Azusa if they want to. Actually, I should just... It didn't matter which order I did that in. And play Celestia Sanctuary. Okay, and then tap this. And then now return Celestia Sanctuary. And then play Primeval Titan. Ooh, we still got our prime time going here. And then yes. And then now I get Boros Garrison plus Slayer Stronghold. And then turbocharge my Titan here. I'm just gonna return the Slayer Stronghold. Haven't played it, don't have any land plays left. Get to hit and get two more lands. So now we want to get one non-bounce land or one bounce land, I think. I guess I would rather play, because if I get a non-bounce land and a bounce land, I have to bounce one of my untapped or one of my tapped bounce lands if I want to cast Coalition Relic, but it's probably worth it still. I guess we can get Ghost Quarter. Actually, we'll just get Colony Garden. And Simic Growth Chamber. Untap. Bounce the Simic Growth Chamber. Opponent takes 8. I just want to make sure I can cast all my, or pay for my Pact obligations next turn. And I can even through Double Cryptic. Yeah. Not that they can cast Double Cryptic, but you know the drill. All right, so that was pretty good. They went for the main phase Cryptic, and then because we peeled Titan, we actually still got Titan that turn. We wouldn't have been able to Titan through a path, but we would have ended up getting a basic, and I think been in okay shape. And then now on this turn, if they have a Supreme Verdict, well, it's less good. I'll say that. but I guess I just at that point have to hope to draw another Titan or something along those lines. Alright. Yeah, I'm getting hit here, so it feels like Supreme Verdict is happening. This is where not having the fourth Teleria West is kind of unfortunate. You can't cast Supreme Verdict that way. Alright. And search for his counter, sure. So let's pay. Yes. Well, it's a Primeval Titan. Not gonna lie. 1, 2, 3. Oh man, this is where having Slayer Stronghold in my hand is actually kind of brutal. Since if it was my deck, I'd still be able to get them this turn. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have to play a land in order to... And I have to tap my Boros Garrison and Slayer Stronghold. So, because otherwise I could get Vesuva... And Vesuva the Slayer Stronghold, but I can't Vesuva both the Boros Garrison and the Slayer Stronghold here. Yeah, I don't think that there is a way for me to get there this turn. Which means I want to play Simic Growth Chamber. Oh, I meant to tap it. Well, it doesn't matter too much, but yes, that was not good. All right, land, and then, well, I definitely want to get Ghost Quarter for Deras Kanta, and I guess at this point I'll just get Academy Ruins. And untap my land, pass. So they might decide to Field of Ruin my Ghost Quarter before they resolve their search here. That is a possibility. but I think that's something that I can live with. If they do that, then I'll Ghost Quarter their Celestial Colonnade. And they end up down a decent amount of mana here. They may even not want to flip the Search for Escanta. I have 7 lands in my hand, so... Oh, my Walking Ballista's gone too. I do have Academy Ruins now, so they also may want to Field of Ruin the Academy Ruins. They have a lot of options for Field of Ruin. Maybe I should have just Ghost Quartered the Field of Ruin? It's actually a pretty strong possibility now that I think about it, since having that Academy Ruins in play instead of in my hand is a lot worse. Maybe I should have just gotten Academy Ruins plus a Bounce Land or something along those lines. Wow. Yeah, there's a lot going on with this deck, I'm not going to lie. Yeah, and then this happens. I get my Forest. Okay, so they have Path or something along those lines. Let's go Trinket Mage. I guess they could have Cryptic, neither, but all right, this resolved. Explosives? Explosives kills Escanta, which is pretty nice. I guess Amulet Vigor does stone nothing, so let's not get that. Slayer Stronghold. Let's go to beginning of combat. I'm just going to... Oh, they're just going to let me attack? Okay. I was going to haste up the Trinket Mage, but I didn't anticipate being allowed to attack. All right, now I'm going to get Sun Home and Vesuva. I'm going to copy Celestial Colonnade. Untap. Untap. I guess I'll Slayer Stronghold the Titan, and now they path it? Or are they going to settle it? Okay, well, I guess not attack with the Trinket Mage is great then. untap my land. Alright, and then I'm going to play Explosives for 2 here to kill their Escanta. Boom. And I already played my land, and then I'll just pass. And then now I've got Trinket Mage threatened to come in for lethal, and then because of my Coalition Relic, I can animate this Celestial Colonnade to get some good attacks in there, too. Okay, we're doing a little better. All right, there's a Teferi. Okay. No real reason to Ghost Quarter their Celestial Colonnade, given that they just get a basic from it, so... That's not good. They're going to play a tapped Hallowed Fountain. All right, let's charge Coalition Relic. And between Sun Home and Slayer Stronghold, I think I'm in good shape here, because now, let's see, let's draw... Or Summoner's Pact, that also does the trick. Let's get white. Let's go Summoner's Pact. I think I was going to be okay before, because I was going to attack with Colonnade Trinket Mage and then give the Trinket Mage +2/+0 Slayer Stronghold. Absorb, okay, that's fine. And then if they dealt with that, I was going to be able to double strike the other one. So now I get to, let's see, Slayer Stronghold. So I just need to play Gemstone Mine, because now I can go Slayer Stronghold my Celestial Colonnade, Sun Home my Celestial Colonnade. just the way Garfield intended. An attack for 14. Okay. Let's put in Spell Pierces and Negates. Let's put in Rurikthar and I guess Emrakul. Let's take out an Explosives. Definitely want all the packs. I think I do want the Sakura Tribe Scouts. I don't actually know that Walking Ballista is good, despite it being a threat there. I guess the appeal of Walking Ballista is that you can get it back with Academy Ruins. I definitely want to take out Kabira Crossroads. And I think Bodruka Bog and Colony Garden. Bog to shut down Search for Escanta just does not seem very effective. I don't think I want Rex Sage unless I see something post-board, which would indicate the need. Yeah, don't want Chameleon Colossus, and don't want Ravenop Excavator, so I think we're good here. Alrighty, time for game two, and ooh, this hand's pretty good. This hand is missing a Bounce Land and a Titan, but it has a lot of the other pieces I'm looking for, including lots of Azusas. Let's just play Sakura Tribe Scout on turn one here, because that can accelerate me into a turn two Azusa, and if I draw Bounce Land or Titan, could get pretty wild. Let's go Academy Ruins. Gemstone Mine, play Azusa here. And I kind of just want to keep the Cavern of Souls in hand. I have the ability to play a lot of lands here. I don't think I need to jam, just because of Field of Ruin. Also, turn one Glacial Fortress, turn two Field of Ruin. Decent chance my opponent has no more lands in hand. Because, yeah, or just something like this. There's not a whole lot of reasons to lead with the lands they did. Well, it doesn't really make sense for them to use Field of Ruin. It's not like my lands are particularly effective either. Unless they really, I guess they really want to get a basic here. Alright, so now I suppose Ancient's Turns do. Okay, I found Celestia Sanctuary. And I get to play a Amulet. I suppose they could have technically tried to Spell Pierce me, but it would not have done a whole lot. I'm just going to attack for one, because I can use Sakura Tribe Scout end of turn if I want. I still don't really want to play Cavern here, because of that Field of Ruin. So now I'm just missing a Titan. They have lots of Field of Ruins, I see. Okay, well, I don't need to use the Sakura Tribe Scout given the Azusa either. Okay, that's not so bad. Are they going to Surgical my Ancient Stirrings? Okay. When Surgicals go wrong. Yeah, that's not going to do a whole lot. I mean, yes, it somewhat reduces the quality of my draws, but honestly, Ancient Stirrings, besides getting Teleria West, doesn't even have that many hits given the current situation. And I don't have one in hand, so it just really doesn't matter. So now I just attack with Azusa, I think, and just pass the turn. I think you want to keep Celestia's Sanctuary in hand because you want to be able to put it into play multiple times a turn, so you want to keep your only Bounce Land in hand. Definitely not expose it to Field of Ruin. Am I going to get Vendilion clicked? Is that what's going on here? Okay. Guess not. And I don't want to expose Cavern of Souls to those same Fields of Ruin, though that's less relevant with a Pact Negation in hand. I just don't have a reason to play all my lands out here. I just need to draw a Titan is what I need to draw. Okay. So I can get to Teleria West here. I just have to use up my Bounce Land, because I get to play Bounce Land, Bounce Gemstone Mine, play Gemstone Mine, Transmute Teleria West, and then end up with enough mana. Field of Ruin's a little annoying. Yeah, that's probably still worth it. Alright. Untap. And my opponent may just Field of Ruin my Celestia Sanctuary here as well. Because that is a reasonable play to make. Alright, well, a lot of blue. They also may Field of Ruin my Gemstone Mine. Not that I think that's super likely, but they could. And Transmute Teleria West. Summoner's Pact. And now I definitely don't want to play the Cavern, because I need that to get to enough lands here. Okay. I guess I should have done that post-attack in case they had Vendilion Click, but anyway. I'm going to pass. They're going to Field of Ruin my... Oh, they're going to Cryptic my Sakura Tribe Scout. There's like wild things going on. I really don't know what to make of it. Okay. Field of Ruin me. This one I expected. I guess if they don't kill Azusa, then I need to draw a land. But that was like kind of already the case. So I'm gonna opt, sure. Basically, any land at all lets me cast Titan this turn. Let's see what we can get. And I sided out 3 lands, so I'm a 26 land deck. Yeah. Are they gonna path Azusa on my draw step? I'm gonna play Cavern named Giant. Play Grove. Summoner's Pact. I mean, I guess technically they can negate the Summoner's Pact. They could also Spell Pierce the Summoner's Pact. And then I would have to like delay for a turn. I can also Pact of Negation back here. So if I Pact of Negation back and I get two... Yeah, this still works just fine. Okay. Because I get to get a lot of lands here. Because I get to go Titan, get Slayer Stronghold, and Boros Garrison. I still haven't played all my lands. And then next turn I have to pay 9 mana and I'll have plenty... Surgical my Teleria Wests? Okay. I mean, that's a reasonable play. Because it does stop me from getting to go off here. But honestly, the position I'm in, I don't even think I was getting Teleria West anyway. Alright, let's get prime time. Because now I think... I guess technically I should have used the Cavern. I just was like kind of off it. Alright, Slayer Stronghold. Boros Garrison. Untap. Give Titan haste. Bounce. I guess Gemstone Mine's probably the land to bounce because I haven't played all my lands yet. Attack. Now I definitely have to just get two Simic Growth Chambers. And then put these all on the stack. Untap, untap. Bounce. And bounce. And then opponent takes 9. I play Gemstone Mine. And then I'm out of lands. And I guess I don't want to even play the Skur Tribe Scout. I'll pass. And then next turn I can pay for both packs fairly easily. I'm probably going to get Wrathed here. But next turn I can pay... 2, 3, 4. I'm one short of... paying for both packs and then playing Sakura Tribe Scout and using Slayer Stronghold on it. And if my opponent kills my Simic Growth Chamber, I still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Exactly enough to pay for both packs. Despite not getting a basic. Your basic. I get to go blue, blue, then green, green, and then, assuming one of the Growth Chambers is gone, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 extra mana, plus blue, blue, green, green. Enough to pay the piper. Alright, opponent played a land. Exciting. And they may have... Okay, they're not going to use Field of Ruin plus anything else. So let's go ahead and... Alright. Blue, blue, green, green. 1, 2. So... 3 more. Yeah. I guess that's fine. Alright. 1, 2, 3. And then pay to prevent this. Yes. Draw. Just gonna go to my attack. I assume I'm getting cryptic or something here. Oh, am I getting settled? I guess I'll just attack with the Titan then. I'll let my opponent settle me, that's fine. And here I want to get Sunhome and Vesuva. Yeah. And then I'm going to copy Slayer Stronghold. And then untap some lands here. And my opponent also has to have Settle the Wreckage here, which I kind of assume they do. Kind of weird if they didn't. I wanted two copies of Slayer Stronghold because that is what's going to let me kill my opponent with these crappy things in play. They could also just have Path and they're getting me by leaving all their mana up. But if they had path, they would have just pathed the Titan before attacking, presumably. I mean, the same is true of, like, Cryptic. They're going to Field of Ruin my Boros Garrison. I have no lands left to get. It's okay, I've got two fully loaded gemstone mines ready to go. And then now they're going to settle me. Okay. And gemstone mine. Sure, Academy Ruins. And no reason to play Cavern, I don't think. I can name Snake, Shaman, Scout, Human, Monk, Giant. None of them overlap. And what's next? So, if they don't have Path, they could have Cryptic, I suppose. Probably don't have Supreme Verdict. It's certainly up to Teferi. A lot of options here for my opposition. Alright, they didn't play anything in the turn. Oh, they do have Teferi. Okay. They are going to draw a card. Okay. Drawing out a Titan would be pretty nice. Skrull Tribe Scout. Slayer's Stronghold using those two lands. I think that's all I can do for now. Attack my opponent for four here. And hope they don't have path. Yeah, having to get all the lands to protect myself from all those packs was costly. I will admit that. Because now I'm in a spot where my opponent's got an active Teferi out and I'm not killing them right away. That's like a lot less good than you would want. Okay, well, Vanillion Click's fine. I mean, I don't like it because they can just let my hand be and then block the Sakura Tribe Scout and go to five, and then they're just beating me with Teferi. On the other hand, if I do draw another Titan, then I'm in pretty good shape. Oh, they're just going to take it. Oh, no, they're going to blockers. Yeah, they're unsurprisingly not letting anything die. All right, let's just play Sakura Tribe Scout. I think it's fine just to play it. Because if they Wrath, I already have Azusa, and it's not all that likely they have Wrath given they played this game. Surgical of my Teleria Wastes did do some work, though. Alright. Any Primeval Titans? Ooh. What are we using all this mana to Teferi for? Nothing? Why'd you float the mana then? Come on. Ooh. Okay, so maybe it's actually just bad to side out Walking Ballista given Trinket Mage. I could have caverned it. I really want to save that for a Primeval Titan, though. Pulling deep in the tank here. They're actually going to run out of time if they don't shape up here. All right, here comes Snapcaster Mage. Suppose that resolves. Into Cryptic, and like it to Cryptic. Countertap. Okay. I could Azusa and then Slayer Stronghold it, but then they could just block a Snapcaster, so I don't really want to do that. Let's just play Explosives. Oh, I guess can pop explosives for two. Play. I guess I can actually do it all. Is that worth it? Probably. I have to sack an Azusa for that. I'm just gonna wait. Doesn't sound great to me. Getting Teferi'd right out of this game. This is an experience I've had before. it. So we're going to need a Titan pretty quickly here. The problem is they at this point, they probably have... I'm just going to pop Explosives in a turn. They probably have Path. This is a weird, like, full art looking Snapcaster deal. What's going on there? To untap their colony to draw. Instead of activating Sakura... So if I can place Sakura, I can place a Sakura Tribe Scout... And I could Slayer Stronghold it, but they could just block it with Celestial Colony. So I think I'm just going to attack my opponent with both my creatures here. And see what they block and decide whether to Slayer Stronghold accordingly. Another Snappy. Okay. Snappy into Settle the Wreckage. Alright. No... And pass the turn, I guess. I mean, I could play one of my creatures. I'm not sure how much that helps matters. All right, here comes Serum Visions. And tap Talent Fountain. All right. Titan or bust, I guess. Also, Titan might still be a bust. All right. I think I'm just dead here. Okay, so I do want the Ballista back in my deck. Oh, I guess I had Emrakul in my deck. Probably wanna hang on just for Emrakul, and then I'll take out one Sakura Tribe Scout. Alright. Well, let's do this thing. Alrighty, time for round three. I would like to play first, and... Yeah, I'm gonna keep this hand. This hand could use a little help. I'm just gonna start with Teleria West here and hope to hit a bounce land, basically. Ooh, there's a bounce land. Bounce Arena. Alright. Let's return Teleria West, and then next turn I can just go Azusa into play some lands. Is my plan here. Ghost Quarter. I'm saving the Cavern for Titan here, because there's not that many counterspells my opponent can have in this particular spot. And play those two lands and pass, and then... So that's a turn three Azusa, and then I'm just going to have turn four just play Titan. Ooh, does my opponent have Path? Oh, yeah. They've got Path. It's okay. If they Path my Titan, I can live with that. Given my hand here. Okay, draw. Okay. Unfortunately, that does stop me from tightening this turn. Alright, get some lands. Just gonna play my Teleria West and pass the turn here. I do have an uncounterable Titan next turn and then potentially many turns thereafter. Alright, Cavern of Souls, Giant. Yes, Titan is a Giant. Boom. To leave Gemstone Mine up here, and then I don't get to attack this turn, but I actually still think, given my hand, that I do get Slayer Stronghold and Boros Garrison. And then I can still return to Teleria West here, because that way next turn I could potentially haste up my other Titan, because I've got more Titans coming. My opponent definitely has Cryptic Command in hand. That's no surprise. Okay. Yeah, they're super dead here. Now, Amulet Vigor, that was pretty spicy. So now I get Titan. Let's go three here. And because I hit Amulet, I can go Vesuva, Simic Growth Chamber. Copy Boros Garrison. And this Amulet deck can work a control deck, so I will say that. Return a land. And now I guess I'll return a forest. Sure. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah. Sunhome. I haven't played a land, so now I get to hit for millions here because I get to attack. And then I want to get a gemstone mine and pr- probably another growth chamber here. Because I want to be able to use Sun Home on the Titan. Because now, once I put my opponent to 2, now I can just easily kill them with a... like a Walking Blister or something. And I have a Negate up for... might as well. Just have Negate up and... Well, when this deck does the thing, it really does the thing. I haven't had any of the truly busted, like, turn 3 Titan draws, but this was still... I mean, this was a turn 5 Titan, turn 6 Titan, and that certainly was more than enough to dispatch my opponent here. Okay, so now... there are 2, so now I think I just go to my attack here. Opponent's gonna like path or cryptic or something, so they get to tap. What are they even doing? I have to like look at the game log here. Tap draw. Yeah, that's fine. Then I go transmute Talaria West. Give me a Walking Ballista and play a Walking Ballista for enough. And then I have Negate back up in case they somehow had a Negate, and bam! We did it. We are victorious. Let's move on to that. Alrighty, welcome to round 3, and a reminder, this video is, of course, brought to you by ChannelFireball.com. It's your best source for free magic strategy on the internet. Channel Fireball has tons of free articles, videos, and is a great place to buy and sell cards. So remember to check out ChannelFireball.com, and you get a 30% bonus on trading cards if you use our buy list, so... go ahead and do that. That's for store credit, of course. And I'm going to keep this hand. This hand's borderline because it's a little slow. But if it finds an amulet, it goes off pretty quickly. And it's got Azusa, Bounce Land, Titan. It's got all the pieces it needs. Okay, so now I'm actually going to go Forest. Stirrings, look for an amulet here. Ooh, I found an amulet. And that's going to work out pretty nicely because now I get to go turn 2... amulet and probably just Talaria West at that point, but we'll see what my opponent does here. Eidolon of the Great Revel, yeah, that's unfortunate. And I take 1 here, and I'm actually just gonna play Talaria West and play amulet. The reason I'm doing it that way is I don't really need to untap the Talaria West. Puts less triggers on the stack. It's pretty smart. So the next turn I can go Sanctuary, bounce it, play Azusa. And I don't, unfortunately, get to play a Titan next turn, but Azusa might eat a burn spell, and then if I draw another amulet, then I can actually just Titan next turn, I believe. Okay, double Swift Spear. That's unfortunate, because if my opponent has Lava Spike or Lightning Bolt here, I'm going to take a lot of damage, so I'm probably pretty dead. I mean, I'm sure they've got a burn spell ready to roll, at which point I'm taking 6 plus the burn is 9. Oh, another Swift Spear. Interesting. But they don't have a land in hand. So I'm taking 5 here. I guess if I find another amulet off Ancient Stirrings, maybe this actually does the trick. Let's see. I know I have to take extra damage here. That's not an amulet at all, unfortunately. So now let's place him in Growth Chamber. Untap it, tap it. Bounce him in Growth Chamber. Play Azusa, go to 7 here. And then I can play 2 additional lands, but that's not gonna get me there. So I'm gonna play Growth Chamber. Untap it. Bounce a forest and play a forest and then pass the turn. So I have a Titan next turn. Almost assuredly not good enough. Especially since any burn spell, I go to 4. Yeah, I just die here. Alright. Wheel. Post board. Can play another explosives. We can play some negates. And can play some paths. Let's see, what do I not want? Do not want Pact of Negation. This is actually a matchup where I don't think you want to go overboard, because you really still want to just try to optimize for speed. It's possible Coalition Relic. It's not the plan, but on the play, I think a turn 3 Coalition Relic, turn 4 Titan is probably going to be good enough. Path is a little awkward because it's not like you can cast Path on turn 1. So maybe I just don't even go bother too much. I just take out Pact Negation for a third Explosives. And I guess this is where lacking a life gain card on the sideboard can come back to bite you. All right, I would like to play first. Okay, this hand has a lot of what I'm looking for here. I am going to play a turn 1 Sakura Tribe Scout. And I really need to find a bounce land here. But if I find a bounce land, I have Amulet, Titan, Azusa, Sakura Tribe Scout. I have all the rest of the tools, so this hand's pretty good. Oh, Wild Nakata, interesting. Okay, there's the bounce land. So can I Titan here? So if I play Amulet, play bounce land, return it, bounce land, Azusa. So we're not quite to turn 2 bounce land, or turn 2 Titan, right? Again, Amulet, Sanctuary, and Sakura Tribe Scout is 4 mana. Playing Azusa gives me back to 1 mana and gets me up to 5 mana. So given that, I'm going to play Amulet. And I'm going to play Sakura Tribe Scout, I think. Yeah, I think that's worth it. And then I'll pass the turn here. And I could play Azusa here, but I feel like just waiting a turn and just being able to go off with these Sakura Tribe Scouts is good. Hopefully my opponent doesn't kill the Amulet here. Okay. Swift Spear's fine. And they're going to Goblin Guide. Okay. Yeah, this should be good then. They're going to hit me for 6 here. I might even find another land. Didn't. Oh, I found a Primeval Titan. That's actually not so bad. So now I can go Celestia Sanctuary, put these on the stack, untap, tap for mana, bounce this, play Azusa, play Celestia Sanctuary, put these on the stack, untap, tap, return this, whoop, Sanctuary. Yeah, so now what we're going to end up here is okay, I already played on my land, so now I get to Sakura Tribe Scout. Do the same thing. I'm going to end up resolving a Titan. And then Titan gets me Boros Garrison plus Slayer Stronghold. Which conveniently enough also gives Vigilance. So I'm also not able... I'm able to keep the Titan back as a blocker. They're at 15. I can just kill them this turn. All right, so now I'm going to return... I think returning Boros Garrison is fine, because now I get to attack with the Titan. Tap this to put a Boros Garrison into play, because now I'm going to untap the Boros Garrison. Tap this for red. I guess actually at this point I'll return a Slayer Stronghold. And then now I get to get a Sun Home, Fortress of the Legion. And it just doesn't matter. Another bounce land, I guess. And then I get to untap, double strike the Titan. Ooh, this is a nice turn 3 kill here. And bam, there we go. All right, well, I'm on the draw. I definitely want the 3 explosives against the Naiad burn deck with Nakadals and Swift Spears and Goblin Guides. Question is, do I want Path to Exile? I still don't think so. I could put in Rexage because this kills Idol on the Great Revel, and it could kill like a Blood Moon if they have it. I still think Trinket Mage is okay. Maybe I take out one Coalition Relic on the draw here. Walking Ballista is also a little bit dicey, but I don't think I'm necessarily supposed to. I guess I could take out a Walking Ballista for a Path to Exile, or not. Or my opponent submitted, and this is what we're running with. So this hand has no Amulet. It does have Titan, Azusa, bounce lands. This hand's really slow. I think I've got a mulligan this hand. I think I've got to keep this and really hope to draw Sakura Tribe Scout or an Amulet here. I don't know. Maybe I'm supposed to mulligan to 5. It's rough. This matchup, especially on the draw, when you don't have much in the way of sideboard cards. I guess I could try to mulligan to an Engineered Explosives here. Let's see what we draw. Simic Growth Chamber. That's not what I was looking for. And unfortunately, you can't just summon a pack for a Skrull Tribe Scout. That does not work that way. And here... Okay, so I've got some draw steps to try to find explosives. I've essentially got two draw steps. Well, Teleria West is close. I'm not going to have the time, though, to Teleria West and go get explosives. If I find an engineer explosives this turn, I might have a chance. I got a 12. I'm taking 7. No, I'm probably just dead. A Tarka's Command? Oh, yeah, I'm just dead. Well, my opponent also killed me turn 3. Welcome to Modern, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get on to our next match. Alrighty, welcome to round 4 here. We are on the draw this round. Let's see what our opening hand looks like. Alright, and... I guess I'm going to mulligan this hand. This hand, not even close to being keepable. This hand, on the other hand, is quite keepable. Yeah, I'm actually going to put Ancient Stirrings on top. I'm missing a Titan, but Ancient Stirrings finds me a lot of the cards I'm looking for. Ooh, playing against... Looks like blue-white control here. Stirrings into... Well, I guess we'll just get a forest here. That was not exactly what I was looking for. Next turn, I'm probably going to Stirrings again, then just play a Bounce Land. Oh, there's an Amulet. Okay, well, let's Stirrings again. I have nothing to do with the mana, so I'd rather Stirrings to see if my opponent goes to counter it. They did not. I guess here I'll take Academy Ruins. Then I'll just play the Bounce Land. Though, actually, one reason not to take the Forest I'm thinking of in retrospect is that I'm playing against a deck with Path to Exile and Field of Ruin, so taking one of the two basics out of the deck just makes those cards a little bit more effective against me. Let's play another Ancient Stirrings. Let's pick up another Amulet. They don't know I have the first Amulet, so I'm just going to play this one. If my opponent counters it, that's fine. And then I'm going to go Forest into Amulet. And pass the turn. Next turn I can play a 2-2 Ballista. That's not super impressive. So what am I missing now? What I'm missing now is a Titan and a Cavern of Souls. I'll have the time to find those things against blue-white most of the time. Oh, they have Ghost Quarter. Oh no, if they play a Jace, that's unfortunate. So now, yeah, now that speeds up my clock quite a bit. Though Walking Ballista helps a tad, because now I can play a 2-2 Ballista and start to threaten Jace. See if my opponent, they're considering plus 2-ing on me, but they don't know what I'm missing, but obviously if they see a Titan or Summoner's Pack, they're probably gonna ship it. Ooh, if I draw an Azusa as well, I can play Azusa, Triple Sanctuary, Walking Ballista, and then gun down Jace immediately. That'd be pretty sweet. I would not mind running that. That's not exactly what I want to draw. Let's play Celestia Sanctuary. I'm just going to let this one stay in play. I don't need the extra land. Let's just return to forest and play Walking Ballista for 2 here. And pass. This way I can attack the Jace, and then I do have Academy Runes plus Gemstone Mine, so I can eventually start using Academy Runes to get back the Walking Ballista if it becomes necessary to do so. But unfortunately, them getting double Jace activation, probably triple Jace activation here, is going to make things a lot harder for me. This matchup is not so bad, but an early Jace is one of the hardest things for the Amulet deck to beat, especially when it's got a kind of slow a slow start and not a whole lot of ways to get past like a counterspell. So, all right, if they're on 5 mana, they're passing. Okay, well that means I'm gonna be able to take down Jace. Oh, there's a Summoner's Pact. So I'm not going to go for that yet, because I think that the odds of my opponent is like a Cryptic Command or something is way too high. Now I get to actually kill Jace, which is nice. Because if they kill... This is why I think if they had a Path or something, they wanted to use it earlier. Because now if they go to kill Ballista, I can pump it and kill Jason response. Alright. Let's put a counter on this. I guess they couldn't with Blessed Alliance. Interesting. Doink. Doink. And yoink. Alright. Kill Jace. And then I'm probably not gonna play. Yeah, I'm not gonna use Academy Ruins next turn, I don't think. So I think I'd rather just play Forest and Pass. My opponent can Ghost Quarter me to reduce me down to 3-4 mana because I can get a Forest to replace Celestia Sanctuary, but don't feel too bad. Another Jace. Okay, so now I'm gonna go for Titan and hope they don't have Remand or Mana Leak, I guess. Oh, well, I don't mind them using the plus 2 on me because I already have a lot of the cards I need. Let's see. So they put a card on bottom. If they put a card on top, there's actually an argument for upkeep Summoner's Pacting because I'm going to go for it this turn anyway. And now I think I play... Actually, I think I play Sun Home, yeah. I don't like this position. I think it's pretty likely my opponent has a counterspell, but I don't think with a Jason play, I can't really wait around to try to draw Cavern of Souls. So even if... they didn't have a counter. Okay, well, they have... I'm going to go for it anyway, even though I think that they're going to use their Ghost Quarter. Actually, you know what? I'm not going to go for it. Basically, if I get Boros, Garrison, Slayer, Stronghold, and the Ghost Quarter, I'm unable to get an attack in with the Titan. So I think I just get Talaria West, Simic, Growth Chamber. Because this way I can... If they use the Ghost Quarter, they can still disrupt this plan. But at least this way, I'm able to get something out of it. Or I leave myself with more options later. All right, let's transmute. Actually, let's play a Coalition Relic. I can transmute at some point later. And then put a charge counter on it and pass. Because next turn I'm going to be paying the price here for my Summoner's Pact. They had nothing interesting. But yeah, basically if I gotten Slayer's Stronghold and Boros Garrison, my opponent would have just Ghost Quartered. Whereas if I got Growth Chamber, Talarios, they could still Ghost Quarter. That actually still shuts me off. They can kill the Talaria West. But I still have Slayer's Stronghold and Garrison in my deck, which is more valuable because I have more redundant copies of Growth Chamber and Talaria West. So I'm pretty happy with how this has gone. I'm surprised that my opponent just didn't have a Cryptic. It felt like they did, but I guess they're just going to let me go ahead and do this. All right, so now they brainstormed with Jace, and Supreme Verdict is probably what they're playing here. They're going to kill my Titan. But next turn I can pay. I can search. I can still play another Titan next turn. And if they couldn't counter this one, there's like a decent chance I get to just play another one. Okay, so Supreme Verdict happens. They're passing the turn. I'm going to pay for Summoner's Pact. I'm going to draw. Ooh, I drew the Boros Garrison. It's not really what I wanted to do. That was the whole point of the last thing. I can't Titan here. That's unfortunate. I don't have quite enough mana. So I think what I do instead, I think I just play the Boros Garrison. Yeah, that seems fine. Yeah, I'm gonna return Sun Home. And I'm gonna ship the turn here. Let my opponent decide what they want to do. Opt. Right, I'm going to charge my relic so I can F6 here. And opponent gets to presumably put something on the bottom because they brainstormed with Jace, but who knows. Let's see. Oh, they kept it on top. So they want access to all their cards. I don't like that very much. Wall of Omens. Yeah, that one's fine with me. So next turn, I'm going to have a lot of mana. Next turn, a really good draw would be Cavern of Souls. I would not mind drawing that, an Ancient Stirrings, even a Talaria West, we'll see. Port does have, oh, an Azusa, interesting. Oh, they're going to Vendilion click me on my draw step? Well, that's kind of unfortunate. So now I'm hoping, oh, they're going to Surgical Primeval Titans? Oh, that's gross. Oof. I don't know how easily I can win now. Given that they got all my Titans, I could try to string together a win with Azusas and whatnot. All right, that's going to be good enough. I guess I should have scooped in response, but it doesn't matter too much. All right, well, I'm putting in Rurik. I'm putting in the Boom Booms. Rurik, Emrakul, Ramunap Excavator, and Counterspells. Taking out Explosives. I actually did come to the conclusion that I wanted to keep the Walking Ballista. Just because of Trinket Mage and Talaria West. Kabira Crossroads and Budrikabob getting Bog. Bob? Bog. Getting out. Rexage can kill Search for Azkanta. Can kill Crucible of Worlds. Not like super hype about that. I could also take out Calmly Garden if I wanted something else. I don't really want explosives here. I think this is probably going to be fine. Alrighty, welcome to game two. I would like to play first, and oh man. Is this hand keepable despite yeah, I'm going to keep this hand. So, it's pretty awkward. So I get to play Eternal and Vesuva. And it doesn't do anything. There's no action item there. Vesuva doesn't do a single thing, but it has everything else I need, and I get to play Bounce Land on turn two. So, it ends up being okay. It's just kind of funny that ye old Vesuva here. So now I get to turn two play Amulet. It would really nice to be able to resolve Eternal and Amulet, but turn two Amulet and from that, I can play a Coalition Relic. I think... Oh, they're going to play Search for Azkanta. Wall of Omens? Great. Okay, that works out really nicely for me. Because now I can go Amulet. Celestia Sanctuary. Return of Land. Azusa. Celestia Sanctuary. Return of Land. And then now I can actually just play Ghost Quarter. Coalition Relic, and then Charge Relic. Alright, that was a pretty good turn two, because now I'm going to have a turn three, if they don't kill Azusa, turn three Titan with Negate backup. If they do kill Azusa, just play a turn three Titan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if they kill Azusa, oh no, if they path Azusa, I do have Negate backup. Alright. Add blue, let's just play Celestia Sanctuary, because that's the one they know about. Return... And I don't need to play... I do need to play one more time so I can have Negate up. Okay. And then now... Play Titan. They, at best, have a Counterspell. Okay. Well, they didn't. So now I get Boros Garrison and Slayer's Stronghold. Yes, 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 yes. And then now... I get to Moons over Miami here. Boom, boom, boom. Tap this. Actually, I'm going to bounce the Sanctuary, whatever. And I guess I'll go to my attack here. This also even protects me from Blessed Alliance. I mean, my opponent's just like mega dead here. I don't really see them coming back from this. Now I get Talaria West, Simic Growth Chamber. Put these on the stack. Untap. Tap for blue. Oh, I guess tapping for blue doesn't really do much. Whatever. Bounce this. There's no real point in getting Slayer Stronghold. A Snapcaster Mage? Okay. Make it to kill my Azusa. I guess that robs me of a land play, but I think I'm going to be okay here. I suppose that there's a good chance they would take Blessed Alliance out of their deck, so attacking with Azusa didn't do a whole lot. Yes, 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 I know I'm losing a mana here. I'm going to be okay with that. And the good thing is I didn't even have to use Summoner's Pack, so next turn I have tons of mana still. And I can't play a land because I didn't Azusa. Alright, well, I'm just going to pass. I want to leave Negate up because next turn I can still Teleria West Titan my opponent. Charge Relic. And those, and this protect me against Jace. I guess Jace didn't matter. So maybe leaving Negate up wasn't good because I can't counter Supreme Verdict anyway. Okay, Trinket Mage is not really what I'm looking for here. Oh, they're going to cranial surgical extraction me. Yeah, I'm going to actually... I'm going to tap this for blue. I'm going to negate that like this. Oh, they had double surgical? Okay. That's unfortunate. Double surgical might be a little rough. I've got a win now with like Trinket Mage Walking Ballista. All right, challenge accepted, I suppose. I mean, I can also just get a Rurik Thar and play it at some point. My opponent's down to 11 here. So I can't... No, I'm 1 minute short of casting Rurik Thar this turn. Because I can transmute and all that, but it doesn't quite get me there. So now I think I'm going to play Trinket Mage, get a Walking Ballista, and then Slayer Stronghold the Trinket Mage and attack for 7. I think that is my plan here. Alright, so now add blue. And play Trinket Mage. Yes. Walking Ballista. Slayer Stronghold the Trinket Mage. And then post combat, I'm just going to play another Simic Growth Chamber. And then return, I think, just the Ghost Quarter. Pass the turn. And now I think I'm still in like pretty decent shape. Like, my opponent has to make some plays here. I still have Teleria West for Summoner's Pact into Rurik Thar. And the combination of Trinket Mage and Slayer Stronghold and Walking Ballista means my opponent will have to take game actions here in order to not die to the crappy little things I have in play. At some point, I could also T-West for Pact of Negation if I really needed to. All right, here comes nothing. Nothing. So now what? I think I just go to attack with Trinket Mage. And see what my opponent does here. Feels like they have Cryptic Command. Alright, so let's see if they block. Okay, they're going to play a Vendilion Click to block. Oh no, they're going to play Arresto? Okay. Yeah, let's just go ahead and Boros Garrison to trade here. And I think I'm just going to play a big Walking Ballista. Seems fine to me. And then now I get to play Ballista for 3 here. And then I get to charge Relic as well. And this, again, just forces them to answer Walking Ballista. And at some point I can use Teleria West to get Academy Runes and just loop Ballista to kill them that way. Alright, so I'm just going to nug my opponent for 3 here. And I'm not going to let the path resolve. And then they're going to pass potentially with Cryptic up here. Let's charge my Relic. And then draw. All right, so let's get blue. Let's see, do I have enough to do everything? I can transmute twice. Yeah, I guess I do. So I'm going to transmute Teleria West. I'm going to get Pact of Negation. Transmute Teleria West. I'm going to get Summoner's Pact. And then I'm going to play Simic Growth Chamber. Untap. Tap for mana, tap for mana, tap for mana. I'm just going to bounce the Celestia Sanctuary because it's the worst of the lands. And then I'm going to Summoner's Pact. And my plan is to get Rurik Thar here. And let's see what my opponent does. So if this resolves, they can't cast any non-creature spells. I do have a little bit of a risk here. I have 9 mana and 9 mana worth of packs to pay. If my opponent counters this, makes me use Pact of Negation, and then has Field of Ruin or Ghost Quarter, I will lose to my packs. But any non-creature spell does not do the trick, so they're dead to everything else. So I think this is worth going for. I suppose I could have waited a turn to try to make this whole play and be protected from Ghost Quarter, but my opponent would have played Ghost Quarter or Field of Ruin if they had it. Then the longer it goes, the more likely they are to find multiple answers, like Cryptic plus Negate or something along those lines. All right, and that'll do it. So let's head to game 3 here, see if we want to sideboard anything else. I don't think so. I think we're good the way we are here. Alrighty, welcome to game 3, and this hand has everything that I could possibly want, except I guess an untapped land on turn 1, to have the turn 1 amulet, but still, this is pretty nice, and I think I'm just going to go for it. I'm going to play amulet here. Alright, they did not have an answer. That's good. And I think I'm going to return the Teleria West here, and then Ancient Stirrings. I should be able to find another land here. All right, I did. Coalition Relic. Yeah, I'm just going to get Simic Growth Chamber, though. And then that will do it for this turn. Next turn, I get to play an Azusa, I suppose, is the plan. Watery Grave, is that for your surgicals that I've got to be on the lookout for? Okay, so, and second amulet. Actually, that's actually kind of insane. So now, if this resolves, actually, if my opponent goes to counter this, I think I packed. Because now if this resolves, I go Growth Chamber, untap, 5 mana, Azusa, go to 2 mana. Growth Chamber, go to 10 mana. Titan, like, I just get to go off here. All right, so let's put these on the stack. Tap these. I'll return a Growth Chamber, sure. Azusa. And then now they're going to use their counter here. Or are they going to Vendilion click me? Well, I was just like a... No, it can't be a Logic Knot. I mean, I guess they can... If they have Logic Knot, I can just pay it. Because each Growth Chamber adds 4 mana, and I get 2 additional Growth Chamber plays. And so here I can go Growth Chamber, bounce it, and then I can actually maybe go Teleria West, untap, just so I end up with more actual lands in play in case I need to use this Pact of Negation here. This is a pretty sweet turn 3. Turn 3 Titan with Pact backup. I'm into it. Let's see what my opponent's got here. They've got something. It feels like a Logic Knot, but I'm not sure. If they really wanted to, they could surgical my Ancient Stirrings and then Logic Knot for 3. That is pretty aggressive, though. Okay, so Azusa resolves. Let's play Simic Growth Chamber. Untap. So I actually don't even need to play another land here before playing Titan. Untap. So the question now is, does my opponent have Logic Knot? It kind of feels like they do. I'm just going to play Teleria West. Untap. And then play Titan. and see what comes of it. Okay, so Titan resolves. And then now I'm definitely going to get Boros Garrison plus Slayer Stronghold. And then, so now I get to untap. Oh, I guess I did stack it kind of correctly. Give this Vigilance and Haste. Untap. Untap. I'm going to bounce the Teleria West here. So now I can actually go for the kill, I suppose. No reason to do this before attacks. So let's just continue. Yeah. See what happens if I get to attack. Okay, they do have a path. So the question now is, do I want to use Pact of Negation or not? I could also Slayer Stronghold Man Zeus. So if I pact, they can't logic not me, I guess. I think it's probably worth pacting here. If they have another counter, they just have to counter the pact. I don't end up on the hook for pact. I guess if they have another path, it's kind of annoying. Okay. And at this point, I've already played out all my lands. All right. Huh. So I'm actually going to lose my own pact negation now. Wait. Let's see. Is there a way out of this? Because now I get to get a forest and untap it. Yeah. And I guess actually the second path was critical to, like, I shouldn't have played the pack because the second path actually gets me too good there. Because now, next turn, I'm going to get pacted on upkeep, and there's nothing I can do about that. I guess I can play another Azusa. That doesn't actually work, though, I don't think. Because that doesn't let me play additional lands. Wow, good beats. Did not expect the double path to exile. All right. See, this is why we play this deck. We get to learn sweet things. So if I just let path resolve there, I'm far from guaranteed to win. Yeah, maybe I didn't. Oh, they're just gonna get to field me just for additional value. Maybe so if I let path resolve, I end up with not enough blue to transmute Teleria West. So I still end up potentially losing, but. Very interesting. All right. We're going to go for the fifth match because I want to close out this league. Let's see if we can get a winning record. Alrighty, welcome to round five. We are 2-2. I'm going to keep this hand. It's got Amulet. It's got Bounce Lands. Missing some other pieces of the puzzle, but we'll get there, I'm sure. I could have led with Gemstone Mine, but I think given how much mana I have access to, I don't really need to because... Oh, the double Amulet really helps because it means I don't need a Azusa in order to get a Titan out this game, or a Secure Tribe Scout. Okay, playing against Arclight Phoenix here. Let's see if my opponent is getting in there. Oh, double mana Morphos, interesting. Okay, well, we might be getting hit by some Phoenixes this game. Looks like turn two. How many do you have? Double Phoenix on turn two. Well, that is why you play the deck. All right, let's see what kind of a clock we can present. If we hit a Titan next turn, let's see, so we can play Amulet, and then turn after that we can potentially play a Titan. All right, here's another Amulet. Let's go Amulet. And untap. Untap, all right, whatever. Bounce and Amulet. All right, we have millions of mana. Unfortunately, we do have Slayer Stronghold in hand. I wonder if I'm... Oh, man, I was actually supposed to just leave the Slayer Stronghold in play, probably. Because now I can't... I did draw the Summoner's Pact. I can't actually haste up my Titan. Well, let's still get a Primeval Titan here. Go Growth Chamber. Untap. So, untap it. untap it, untap it, and bounce the Celestia Sanctuary, Titan. Yes, and what are we getting here? Well, since I can't actually attack this turn, probably something like Kabira Crossroads, Talaria West. Okay, so I'm gonna... untap all these thingamajigs. Let's just see how much mana we end up floating with at the end here. And gain two. Oh, I didn't bounce. Sorry, less. That's fine. I didn't get a bounce on. I got a Kabira Crossroads. So next turn we're gonna get to do a lot of action here. Oh. What am I even doing? I can't even pay for Summoner's Pack now. I needed to get double green. Okay, didn't matter. We were dead, but... Alright, well, this is Amulet play at its finest. So I said this is the matchup I think you want paths for. I don't actually think I want Tormod's Crypt all that much here. I guess you can just leave it in play. And it does a thing. I don't like Pact very much here, and... don't really like Walking Ballista a whole lot either, so let's just put in my four path to exiles and roll. Alrighty, welcome to game two on the draw. This hand's nice. This hand has all the tools needed to amulet good. This deck's really good. Takes a lot of practice. See, look, you're watching me level up with Amulet, and by that I mean I've only died to my own packs twice so far. Though, I didn't actually live long enough to die to Pact last game. Okay, so... turn two... if I draw a bounce line, I can play Azusa. But more than likely, I'm going to have to just Ancient Stirrings first. Oh, that's not bad. All right, let's go Ancient Stirrings first to see if we can hit a Bouncerino. We do. But I actually think I just want to play Secure Tribe Scout still. And this leaves me with a Titan next turn if my opponent doesn't do anything. If they bolt Sakura Tribe Scout, I can go Bounce Land, Azusa, Bounce Land, Bounce Land, and don't quite get there. So that's unfortunate. Drawing Sakura Tribe Scout was pretty good, though. If they don't... oh, they didn't play a land? Okay, well, I see... I smell blood. All right, let's bounce... turn this, play Azusa. Growth Chamber, you know the drill. Untap. Bounce. Growth Chamber. Untap. Bounce. And then I get to Sakura Tribe Scout as the last mana needed. And bounce. And then Summoner's Pact. For a Primetime, Primeval Titan, get Slayer's Stronghold plus Boros Garrison. There's the Boros Garrison, and there's the Slayer's Stronghold. Untap, so untap this, tap, untap Slayer's Stronghold, buff the Titan. Alright, and that'll do it. Now turn 3 Titan, NBD. Though I did realize I probably want Rex Agent in case they board in Blood Moon, which they almost always do. And I think on the draw, I could, if I want Tormod's Crypt in the deck, maybe I don't want Trinket Mage, but I think I'm just going to take out the Trinket Mage instead. Okay, game three here. A bunch of paths. Well, this has Amulet, Azusa, and Titan. Needs to find a bounce land, but I'm sure that can be arranged. Turn one, Colony Garden. If they had gone Faithless Looting on turn one, I could have Bojuka Bogged them. That would have been kind of nice. Okay, let's see what we got here. Cavern of Souls. Oh, that's actually pretty good. Let's name Giant and play an Amulet. This way, playing Tron on Amulet's good in case, first of all, it stops, you know, Spell Pierce or something from countering it. And then second, it does mean if I draw Bounce Line on turn two, I can play Azusa right away. Okay, so if they discard Phoenix here but don't have, like, a gut shot, they're not going to be able to put Phoenix into play, and I might be able to snipe them with Bojukabog. Let's see what my opponent does here. And that could be pretty sweet. And because they did not lead with a Metamorphos, they discarded Set Adrift and Snapcaster Mage. Okay. Well, we drew the Simic Growth Chamber. The question is, and so let's say I go Bounce Land, Azusa. Play Bounce Land, they bolt Azusa, I return the Bounce Land. That doesn't end up sounding great. I'm just going to play Colony Garden and pass here. It just feels like it's so likely they have a Lightning Bolt in hand that I don't think I want to slam Azusa quite yet. Hopefully I'm not getting Blood Mooned here. It feels like I am, though. Oh, Explosives for one. Okay, that's fair, I suppose. Didn't really expect that, but that'll do. Oh, well, that was good. So now I can go Amulet. They don't have any mana untapped, so now I get to go return Amulet. Return Growth Chamber. Play Azusa. I don't get to play Titan this turn, but I do think... let's see, the question is... Do I really want to use... let's return Colony Garden. Let's just play Bojukabog. And let's just bog my opponent. Just get their Faithless Looting out. And then now... I guess I'm in a spot where I can't... I can't Titan my opponent, but... If I draw... If Azusa dies, I'm still on track to cast a Titan. That was my main concern, is I just feel like Azusa's probably going to die. Thing in the ice, and then bolt Azusa. So I wanted to leave myself in a position to potentially cast a Titan. So any Bounce Land does the trick here. Oh, they didn't kill Azusa. I guess they might be waiting for upkeep here. Yeah. Okay, Azusa down. Draw. Play Colony Garden. And this is where returning the Bounce Land one too many times actually kind of came back to bite me here. So let's just play a land pass. I can Titan next turn. They might be able to flip Thing in the Ice this turn. If they do that, that's unfortunate, but I can still just Titan and then pass the thing. So I'm feeling pretty good about that. Blood Moon is going to be unfortunate, I think, no matter what. So the question is, yeah, actually, man, it's not, yeah, I can Titan for two, for if I want, I can Titan for two forests in order to play around Blood Moon here. But that means I don't get to path the Awoken Horror. I guess I can path it next turn. All right, I'm going to take 7 here. Go to 13. Draw. Well, Rexage doesn't change that calculus. Because basically, I'm going to get Primeval Titan. And I'm going to play Titan. I guess it doesn't even matter that I have Cavern here. And I'm going to get Slater's Stronghold plus Boros Garrison. I'm going to untap them. I actually think... I bounce Bojukabog here. So now the question is, am I more likely to win by getting... Oh, I actually know what I'm going to do. This is funny. So, because I have two paths, I think I'm going to get Kabira Crossroads and... No, this doesn't quite work. Never mind. I was going to say Kabira Crossroads and Gemstone Mine, and then I could path my Titan to get a forest, but the problem is if they Blood Moon me, I need two forests. So the question is, do I get two forests to play around Blood Moon, or do I get white sources so I can path Awoken Horror? I'm at 13. I think... is really close. So if I don't get any white sources here, I take 7 going to 6 and die to 2 bolts. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna run the risk of getting Blood Mooned here. Doesn't make me like super happy, but I think that's what I'm supposed to do. I'm going to get Kabira Crossroads and Simic Growth Chamber here. Untap my lands. I'm going to bounce Colony Garden here. Path this thing. And then just lose to Blood Moon. Yeah. I mean, it's that, or basically what's more likely, that they have Blood Moon or Phoenix plus Bolt or something. So I guess in the case of Phoenix, I could chump the thing in the ice, but then I also end up with only one white source, so. All right, here's Manamorphos. Oh, they're not slamming Blood Moon. I mean, they easily could have it. And you'd get an island there anyway. Okay, there's another Manamorphos. Oh man, opponent keeping me on the hook here. I need these play points. How else am I going to join more modern events? All right, they're going to Thought Scour themselves, hit Arc Light. See, this is the kind of thing that makes me happier that I played it this way. I end up at 15, and they don't have Thing in the Ice, as opposed to like either chumping or just taking enough damage to, or I could just open the door to lose otherwise, instead of losing to maybe a 2 of if they even have it, which they don't even always have. Opponent's still not sure what they're going for here. And I have to imagine if they had Blood Moon, they would have just played it by now. Well, and there we go. My opponent conceded. We managed to go 3-2. I say we because I messed up a bunch. This deck's hard to play, but it is very good. And I wouldn't be surprised if I had to test with this deck a little more for the Magic Fest, or I guess Pro Tour Mythic Championship. Yeah, one of those things in London. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time as I play a deck with potentially slightly fewer lines of play and a little more confidence.